When playing chess, the outcome of the game is usually determined in the early stages by the positions that are built up by each player even before the first pawn falls. These moves may seem innocuous to the untrained eye, but an experienced player can read the threats which grow and develop in each stage and can see the traps which are being laid. Right now, the nations of the world are organizing and positioning themselves financially, diplomatically, and militarily for a struggle which will alter the global power structure irrevocably. It would be impossible to understand the economic collapse which is slowly unfolding and the great war which will almost certainly follow without taking into account the stakes of this global chess game. The true root of power in the modern world lies in the creation and control of money. In the United States, as in most countries, the power to coin money has fallen into the hands of a handful of powerful banking cartels. Given enough time, financial power always translates into political power. This concept can be summed up by the infamous words of Mayor Rothschild, who said, "Give me control of a nation's money supply, and I care not who makes its laws." The current dollar-dominated monetary structure is nearing the end of its lifespan, and the powers that be have known this for some time now. When the dollar falls, a replacement world reserve currency will be presented. Already there is open talk of using IMF special drawing rights for this purpose. However, there are several key countries, particularly China and Russia, who will not accept Western control of any such replacement. This will be the true cause of World War III. There will be other justifications given, or even apparent attacks on our own soil. There will be the usual talk of fighting terrorism, spreading freedom, and liberating the people of this country or that. But don't be fooled. What's really at stake is the control over the world's monetary system and the global political power which will grow out of it. This is not a subject that I enjoy thinking about, because as a father, I feel the implications of what I'm presenting here deep in my gut. I can understand why many might not want to look at what I'm about to say, and why they might resort to calling me a fearmonger. But consider this. If someone sees a hurricane approaching and does not tell you about it, are they really helping you? I want you to look at this, because how you react to these events will shape the future for generations to come. What's at stake is more than your life, more than your children's life. What's at stake is, in fact, an entire era of human history. The primary psychological tool used to herd the masses in the modern age is the Hegelian dialectic, or in layman's terms, problem, reaction, solution. A problem is created or allowed to develop intentionally, the population reacts, demanding a solution, and then those who created the problem present a solution to the problem, quite often a solution that gives more power to the very groups that caused the problem in the first place. It's important to understand that World War III is not going to be an accident. It will not be an unfortunate chain of events that the United States struggles to avoid. It is in fact a goal, a specific objective that must be reached to force a cultural shift that the population would otherwise never accept. It's only from this context that the events unfolding in the world right now make any sense at all. China and Russia see this coming. Korea and Iran see this coming. This is why these countries are currently in the process of completely revamping their militaries and moving their international trade off of the dollar. This is also why the American people were tricked, under the pretense of 9/11, into invading Iraq and Afghanistan. This is why Obama, or more accurately, those who control Obama, have not and will not end our presence in the Middle East. They'll delay, they'll move troops from one country to the next, but they will not withdraw. Because in times of war, resources are taken by the barrel of the gun, and it is the control of key resources, such as oil, which ultimately determine the outcome of most wars. Whoever is able to maintain control of the primary oil fields of the world will have the most political leverage and the best capacity to wage conventional warfare. However, if World War III does break out, the chances that it will be restrained to conventional warfare are slim to none. Unless we radically change course right now, a nuclear war is baked in the cake. This is why when I talk about the great collapse that's coming, I show buildings in ruins and describe the total end of our way of life. You don't need to be a psychic to see this coming, any more than you need a crystal ball to see a train rushing headlong towards the edge of a cliff and know that a tragedy is about to unfold. I don't hold out much hope that this great war can be stopped. Stopping it would require a total popular uprising, a revolution like we recently saw in Egypt. And in my opinion, the American people are far too distracted and far too sedated for that to happen. My only hope is to alter the reaction. Please, don't look for boogeymen in foreign lands when the dust from the mushroom clouds clear. Don't send your children to kill and be killed for the lies that the media will feed you. Don't hand over what tattered threads of freedom you still possess in the name of security. Don't look to those who have brought you to the brink of the abyss in the futile hope that they will protect you. Because if you do, they will rebuild society in their own image. In the face of the dark times that are coming, we will have a tiny window of opportunity, a razor's edge path that leads to something different. We have a chance to look at the mistakes of history and choose not to repeat them. But what you need to understand is that a positive outcome is not guaranteed. And how those events unfold will depend on what we do right now.